Because Shukadeva Goswami in the spiritual platform is the parrot of Srimati Radharani. See, this parrot of Radharani, when Krishna was returning to the spiritual world, the parrot was also very happy, Shuka parrot. He said, I am feeling so joyful, we are all going back home, back to Goloka. Krishna said, yes, we are going, but you are not going. He said, you have to stay back because there is one very important work you have to do. Later on, you have to give Bhagavatam to whom? Parikshit. So you have to stay back. So the parrot was weeping, I have to stay back alone when all Krishna and associates will go back to Godhead. So that is the same parrot who is none other than Shukadeva Goswami. So later on, once Parvati was asking Lord Shiva for with the desire to learn Srimad Bhagavatam. That's a long story cut short, I will tell you. When Parvati one day happened to see Narada, she was very happy to serve him prasad, Narada, great brahmachari. So while eating prasad, Narada asked, oh Parvati Mata, does your husband tell you everything to you? She said, yes, 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 there is nothing in the world he hides from me, he tells me everything. Because Parvati went on talking blah 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 blah, along with that she said, my husband doesn't hide any confidences to me. So he asked her a question, what is this skulls that he wears in his neck like a garland? So many skulls, did you ask him? She said, that is one thing he has never told me. And Narada said, it may be, he may be wearing the skull of somebody who is very dear other than you. Possibly. Then she became angry. And Narada thought, my business is over now. He got up and went away. Then Shiva returned back and Parvati was in a fuming mood. So Shiva asked, oh Devi, what is the matter? She told the whole story. He said, Narada came and went, therefore you are angry. I can understand, that fellow must have told something. And she said, first of all you tell me, whose skulls are you wearing in your neck? Then she said, you see, every time you become sati and do self-immolation in the house of Daksha, I have collected all those skulls and they are the one I am wearing here, he said. She said, oh really? That's wonderful, keep wearing. She was very happy. Then she said, such a superficial thing as the garland you are wearing, I was not aware till day. Is there any other rahasyam, which is paramarahasyam that you know and you have not told me? And Shiva said, yes. Iti rahasatvat anjasa swam kenaiva bhagavata avidushamapipumsam labhyate. This is the definition Sridhar Swami gives for bhakti, rahasyam. He calls the bhakti as rahasyam. He says, iti rahasyatvar swamukena bhagata bhagavata. Lord himself teaches bhakti to the jivas. Like Krishna speaks to Arjuna. And he says that anjasa means very easily bhakti can be obtained. By whom? Avidusham api pumsam. Even if a person is a not learned person like South Indian Brahman, he can learn bhakti yoga. But the scholars will be bewildered. Very surprising, no? How will a scholar be bewildered? Like that scholar I told you in ITBHU. Scholars are bewildered, but an illiterate can understand the path of bhakti by the grace of the Lord. So, Shiva said, yes, there is one paramarahasyam I have not shared with you, which is Srimad Bhagavatam. Then she became adamant. She said, I have to at any cost listen to it. Then Shiva said, it's a paramarahasyam, I can't tell it very easily. You need to be qualified, it is not publicly spoken. So come, I will take you to one place in Bhubaneswar. Near Bhubaneswar, there is a Ekamravan, single mango tree, Ekamravan. In that entire area ground, there is no other tree, that's the only tree standing. So Shiva sat under the tree along with Devi Parvati and he spoke Srimad Bhagavatam. And that is the time this parrot was roaming all around, and then he came and sat in the tree. And then he heard Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. He's going to begin Bhagavatam class. He thought, what a wonderful combination, coincidence. I have come at the right time when the Bhagavatam is beginning. So Shukadeva wanted to hear that. So as Shiva proceeded speaking Bhagavatam, after three cantos or so, Parvati went to sleep. As some devotees go to drowse. So she didn't say, Who was saying, Parrot was saying. Anyway, after the whole Bhagavatam was over, Parvati said, I didn't listen beyond third canto. And Shiva was shocked. Then if you didn't say, then who said the Then he saw the parrot and he took his trishul and chased. Parrot flew away. You will see, and this is the parrot who is born. The parrot flew, it goes into the mouth of Vedavyasa's wife. And later on he comes out as Shukadeva Goswami. So Shukadeva Goswami is whose parrot? Radharani's parrot. Radharani used to tell Shuka, parrot, Krishna bolo, she will say. Immediately parrot will say, Krishna! Then she will feed a pomegranate in the mouth. Again she will make him chant Krishna. So she will keep feeding fruits. So you can imagine Radharani is holding in her hand this parrot and feeding it pomegranate. And that is the parrot of Shukadeva Goswami. And he is the one glorifying Radha Krishna. So one should know how renounced he was, that he was completely free from all blemish. And such a renounced person is speaking about Radha and Krishna. Generally, in this world, people talk about cinema actors and actresses. And most people who talk about such things, their hearts are putrefied, are rendered impure by talking about such things. If you are singing a duet song, which you heard in a movie, that also brings polluting thoughts in your mind. Whereas, when you talk about Radha and Krishna, which Shukadeva Goswami is speaking, he is the purest personality speaking. So, another personality who glorified Radha Krishna pastimes is Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Aradhya Bhagavan Vrajeshatana Yastadhama Vrindavanam Ramya Kachidupasana Vrajabadu Varginaya Kalpitaha Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanamamalam Prema Pumarto Mahan Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhur Matamidam Tatra Dharana Paraha. You know what he says in this verse? Whom should we worship? Vrindavan Krishna, he says, should be worshipped. Krishna in Vrindavan, who is standing in threefold bending form, playing on his flute. Not the Vasudeva Krishna holding the Shankachakra Gadapadma. He is saying, worship Krishna in Vrindavan with the flute. And then he is saying, who is the devotee we should follow? He is saying, the gopis headed by Radharani. They are the purest devotees. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's opinion is this. So in this way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was such a strict sannyasi. No woman could go near him. Women respected him, but from a distance they would offer obeisances to him. Prabhupada says in 16th chapter, first verse, purport in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Chaitanya only once joked in his life about a woman. And who was that? About his own wife only. And what he joked? He told his mother, your daughter-in-law might have probably taken it. Like that he said and he joked. Any husband is allowed to joke about his wife with her. But other than that, Prabhupada says, Mahaprabhu never... See, very amazing, no? Because Krishna is surrounded by so many sakis on Radharani. There are Paramapreshta sakis, there are Radha Snehadika sakis, Krishna Snehadika sakis, Nitya sakis, Prana sakis, so many type of sakis. So all these sakis are all thousands and thousands of them. Amongst them, 108 is very prominent. And among the 108, 8 are very prominent, whom you see in Mayapur. Those 8 sakis. They are called Paramapreshta sakis, the most dear sakis of Radha and Krishna. And who are these 8 sakis? They are directly expansion of Radharani. When Radharani feels, I want to offer flower some, or I want to offer betel nuts, I want to offer a garland, I want to sing, I want to play mridangam, and Radharani feels like this. She feels, how can I do it alone? So she expands into 8 forms. They're called Kaya Vyuha. They're called. She expands into 8 forms. And although they're called by different names, they're all direct expansions of Radharani. So, in this way, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is appreciating the gopis' devotion to be the topmost, although he was a very strict sannyasi. What does a strict brahmacharya or a sannyasi has got to talk about a boy and a girl unnecessarily? People in renounced order have no business to talk about the lusty affairs between boys and girls. But Radha and Krishna are not an ordinary boy or a girl. Krishna is the Supreme Lord and Radharani is a direct expansion of Krishna. That is mentioned in the scriptures. Shakti, Shakti Matayo, Abedaha, it is said. The Shaktiman and Shakti are inseparable. How? Like a sun and sunlight are inseparable. Kasturi and the fragrance of Kasturi are inseparable. Like that. They are inseparable. Can you separate the heat from the flame? The heat and flame are together. Like that, Radha and Krishna are always worshipped together. So, and they are not ordinary persons. There is a verse in, I think, 10.9.29. Bhagavatam. If you read the purports, he talks about in the Rasa dance. Rasa dance is actually such a dance where, you know, many great personalities wanted to join. Lakshmi herself wanted to join. Now, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to South India, he joked with Venkata Bhatta. Because Venkata Bhatta is a worshipper of Ranganathji. And he asked Venkata Bhatta, "Hey Venkata Bhatta, tell me, why Lakshmi wants to leave her husband Narayana and go and dance with Krishna?" He asked the question. Venkata Bhatta said, "Oh Lord, after all, Narayana and Krishna are same person only ultimately. So maybe Narayana is a little serious and you know, Krishna is in a sportive mood. So she wants to join dancing with Krishna. Is there anything wrong? Is there a bhanga in her chastity?" That's what he asked. And Mahaprabhu said, "That is all right, but my question is, why is she not just standing next to Narayana or sitting at his lotus feet and massaging? But she is developing eagerness to dance with Krishna. That means Krishna is more attractive." So Jiva Goswami has given an explanation. When we talk of Krishna being superior to Narayana, mainly it is the rasa that makes Krishna superior to Narayana, the sweetness of Krishna's behavior. That charmed the heart of Lakshmi. So this was taken note by Kaliya's wives. And their prayer, they said, "Kasyana bhavo nade, kasyana bhavo syana deva vidmahe, tavangri renus parashadhikara, yadvanchaya shrir lalana charattapo, vihaya kaman suchiram dhritavrata." This is the prayer they are saying. My dear Lord, Lakshmi generally stands like this with the gold coins falling from her hands. But in Bilbavan, she is like this. Even today you can see. Go to Bilbavan, you will see Lakshmiji like this. And where is she sitting? In front of Yamuna. On the other side, there are many of the forests of Vrindavan. She is praying to Vrijavasis, "Please come and feed me khichdi, not basmati rice or molten ghee. Feed me, because I am not used to khichdi. In Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha we eat only basmati rice. But here you can feed us khichdi. Why? Because I want to get training to become like a Vrijabasi." And she is also telling, "Let me take inspiration from all of you, because the gopis of Vrindavan handle even the gobar. They milk the cows and cow, you know, they also work in the fields." So she had to become like a rustic girl in order to be accommodated in the rasa dance, but she couldn't. Finally, Krishna told Lakshmi, "Don't worry, I will keep you in my chest as a Srivatsa, golden hair. And you can just watch the dance. You can't dance, but you can watch the dance." Can you imagine? That is the position of the gopis. Not only that, once Lord Shiva wanted to enter Krishna's rasa dance, but he knew very well that only the gopis, girls, little girls, they are only dancing. So he decorated himself also very much like a gopi. So when he, as soon as he was about to enter, Lalita and Vishakha were the screening committee at the door. So they saw this gopi is dressed very nicely, only thing a snake is coming out. So then they asked Krishna, "Who is this gopi with a snake in the neck?" So Krishna said, "Who is this gopi? It's Gopeshwar Mahadev." So he said, Krishna told, "Don't frighten all other gopis with snake. You stand at the door and you also join the screening committee," he said. "You can also be a part of the same." So he was also asked to stand at the door. Like this you will find many great personalities wanted to enter the rasa dance. Others who couldn't enter, what do you think they did? They flew in the sky. You will see in the pictures that Indra and Sachi are flying and showering flowers. You will see Brahma and Saraswati are flying in the sky and showering flowers. Rasa dance entry is allowed for a jiva when the jiva has attained the the topmost position of surrender to Krishna. When we agree to dance according to Krishna's tune, then Krishna dances according to the devotee's tune. In this way, rasa dance is actually both Lord and the devotee dancing according to each other's tune. That entry is not very easy. Even if you can become servant of Krishna in dasya rasa, that's a very great thing. Beyond dasya, there is sakya, there is vatsalya, there is madhurya, in which one dances with Krishna. So Shukadeva Goswami writes in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Vikriditam Brajavadu Viridam Chavishnoho Shraddhanvita Anushunyat Atavarnayedya Bhaktim Param Bhagavati Pratilabhyakamam Hridrogamashvapahinoti Achirena Dhirah. You know what he says? Anybody who hears this playful pastimes of Krishna dancing with the gopis, from someone who speaks on this subject with great transcendental faith. And if someone hears with great transcendental faith, then what will happen, he says, Bhaktim Param Bhagavati Pratilabhya Kamam. In our heart there is lust, but bhakti goes inside and kicks out the lust outside, and only bhakti remains, like that he says. So, when you go to watch movies, adult movies, we get more impure, whereas by hearing the pastimes of Radha Krishna and the gopis, our heart becomes more pure. Lust is driven out, love is bestowed upon the devotee who hears, like that he says. So therefore, not only Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or Shukadeva Goswami, even Shankaracharya has written Gopyashtakam, glorifying the gopis. Gopis are the topmost devotees. So the type of names I am taking, you can think about what is the standard. Who is Shankaracharya and who is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and who is Shukadeva Goswami? So one should know the purity and the sublimity of this pastime. So I told you that verse number 10.9.29, you will find, 10.29.9, not 10.29, 10.29.9. In that verse, purport, it's all given, who are these gopis? Some of the gopis are called Shrutichari gopis. Shruticharis are those who are, Shruti means the Shruti mantras, the Upanishadic mantras and the Vedas, four Vedas. They are considered very potent and very powerful. But they wanted to become gopis. Why? The Vedas said, we are incomplete now. Because we have explained so many things, but the ultimate conclusion of the rasa of the Lord, which is explained in the Vedanta Sutra as raso vai saha, rasam ki evayam labdhvanam, we have not explained it elaborately because we have no experience. So in this time, lifetime, you'll become gopis. Next time when the Vedas are again bestowed by the Lord, at the time it will include this also. So the Vedas wanted to become gopis, Vedas personified. They wanted to become gopis and they were allowed entry also, Shrutichari gopis. Then there were Munichari gopis. They were all in Dandakaranya forest, Lord Rama's devotees. They wanted to serve Ram like the way Sita was serving Ram. So they were allowed entry in Krishna's pastime because Rama was Ekapatni Vrat, he had taken. So they became gopis also. They were all rishis and munis. Like that, Rishichari gopis, Munichari gopis. There is Devakanyaku gopis are those born to demigods and goddesses as daughters but were pure devotees. They were allowed entry also. And you will read in Bhagavatam 10th canto, the only gopis who were not allowed entry were those who were not completely pure at heart. They had a tinge of lust in their heart, so they were not allowed entry. And they also closed their eyes and cried very bitterly for not being allowed entry because their parents and friends, relatives were not allowing them. And they left their bodies. They actually died, but their hearts became completely purified. So eventually they might have joined the rasa dance also. So in this way, Prabhupada explains in Krishna book. I can show you if you want what Prabhupada says. You can see for yourself. See here, Prabhupada is writing here. Another important point is that none of the gopis who danced with Krishna were in their material bodies. They danced with Krishna in their spiritual bodies. All their husbands thought that their wives were sleeping in their sides, and then Prabhupada writes about this. The bodies of the gopis, which were their husbands were lying in the bed, but the spiritual parts and parcels of Krishna were dancing with him. Krishna is the Supreme Person, the whole spirit, and he danced with the spiritual bodies of the gopis. Therefore, there is no reason to accuse Krishna in any way. Correct, no? Can say this. So this is in Krishna book, the Rasa Dance chapter. So you will see in this way. So till now what I have spoken is, I have spoken about Shukadeva Goswami, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Shankaracharya and such great personalities, adoring the gopis as the topmost devotees. That was one thing I told you. Another thing I told you is about the gopis themselves, how they are all in their past lives very exalted and purified sages, and then they are appearing in the rasa dance. So they should not be treated like ordinary simple girls of this world. Then in the beginning I told you all the Lakshmis. Lakshmi is considered the topmost. Even Lakshmi is worshipped by Gauri and Sachi and Saraswati and all. But even that Lakshmi is not only one Lakshmi. Hundreds and thousands of Lakshmis, they are all headed by Radharani as their chief. Kanta Shiromani. That verse I was telling you. There is a verse from Padma Purana also about Radhika Paradevata. Lakshmi Sarvamayi. It says Devi Krishnamayi Prokta Radhika Paradevata. There also it says that Radharani is the supreme Lakshmi, the original Lakshmi, and if all of the Lakshmis come from her eventually. So in this way, now till now I have been telling, I told you that I'll tell you about Krishna, but I got into telling about Radharani and the gopis. So the purity of these personalities and the greatness of these personalities, that's what we have been focusing on. Now about Krishna we will talk a few words. See, this is you will find this in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Srila Rupa Goswami quoting this. Speciality of Krishna, he says, Divya Sargadi Kartratvam. Mahavishnu creates millions of material universes, but Krishna creates both spiritual and material universes. Everything expands from Krishna. Aham Sarvasya Prabhavo, he says. Therefore, he says, Divya Sargadi Kartratvam. Mahavishnu does Sarga and Brahma does Visarga, secondary creation. Whereas the Divya Sarga, the spiritual creation, is made possible by Krishna. Brahma Rudradi Mohanam, he says. You all know Brahma Vimohan Leela. I will not tell you about that. You know it. And you know Lord Rudra was also bewildered by once Mohini Murthy. Correct? But who is this Adi? You may have a question. Besides Brahma and Rudra, was anybody else bewildered? Can you guess? Who? Oh, Indra is not even counted here. Very big personalities like Brahma. Brahma is like the chief living entity, son of the Lord directly. He is talking about Balaram. Balaram was once bewildered. Do you know when in the Brahma Vimohan Leela, Lord Krishna expanded himself into cows and calves and covered boys? That 1 year even Balaram could not guess that Krishna had expanded. 1 year passed. Just 1 week before 1 year was about to be complete, Balaram saw a very strange sight. At that time he saw from the top of Govardhan Hill, big cows were all herding at the top. Cows were herding at the top, calves were herding at the bottom. Not the small calves, the grown-up calves. Grown-up calves don't drink milk. What do they take? Grass. So the cows came running very fastly towards those calves. It appeared that they are running in two legs like this. They were running so fast, coming down the hill. And they all ran towards the bigger calves. And they started licking the body of the calves and feeding them milk. And the cowherd men who picked up the sticks and they came running, they were wondering why the cows are feeding milk to the bigger calves. Why are they doing it for the first time? So although they were angrily running behind, as soon as they saw their small sons who were herding the calves, immediately they fell in love with the sons. They picked up their sons and started smelling their head. At that time Balaram saw this. Balaram was wondering why the fathers are showing too much love for their sons, every one of them. Why are the cows showing too much love for their calves? Something fishy. He thought there must be some secret behind this. Then he called Krishna and said, Hey Kana, What have you done? Tell me. And then Krishna smiled and said, Bhaiya, now what truth can I hide from you? Let me tell you the truth. Then he told the whole story of Vimha Vimohan Lila, what happened. And he said, after 1 week, I will give up all these forms. Then I will bring back all the covered boys and calves. Can any of you guess, why did Krishna keep Balaram in illusion for 1 year? Balaram generally cannot be put into illusion, do you know that? You see, in the Kaliya Mardan Leela, Balaram was laughing while everybody else was weeping. Balaram was the only one laughing because Balaram was never put to illusion to think that Krishna can be defeated by Kali or something. All Vrajavasis were crying, including Yashoda and Nanda also. But Balaram was confident at that time. Then why he did not know Krishna's this expansion program during that 1 year period? Because Krishna thought, if I reveal to Balaram, then Balaram will cry and he will miss his friends like Sridhama, Sudhama, Madhumangal for 1 full year. He will feel the pain. In order to not make him feel the pain, Krishna hid the truth from him for almost 1 year. Therefore, the Adi word is used, Brahma Rudra Adi Mohana. And Bhakta Prarabdha Vidvamsam, he says. That means all of us as devotees, we all have Prarabdha Karma. Prarabdha Karma, one form of Prarabdha Karma is this body which we all have. And another form of Prarabdha Karma is like the diseases we may get in the body. Physical diseases and emotional turmoils. And also our Pap Karma has to be suffered in the next life by going to Yamaloka or something. But Lord can destroy the Prarabdha. Krishna can destroy. What is that? How he does it? Example is Sandipani Muni's son, who was sent to Yamaloka, but Krishna went to Yamaloka and brought him back, and gave him back to his father. Actually, Krishna has done many things like that. He's gone to Yamaloka and brought son of Guru back. He went to Varuna Loka and brought Nanda Baba back. He went to Mahavishnu Loka and brought the four sons of Brahmana back. So, our Rupa Goswami explains these things to show how Krishna is very unique. And amongst the uniqueness of Krishna, these four are the topmost, four exclusive qualities. Please repeat this verse. Sarvadbhuta chamatkara Leela kallola varidhi. See, sarva adbhuta chamatkara. He's saying, Krishna shows an astonishing display of Leela. And kallola, you know what's the meaning of kallola in Sanskrit? When two waves in the ocean come like this, and they hit like this, that is called kallola. And they hit and they sprinkle. Similarly, why there are different waves in Krishna's pastime? One wave is Vatsalya wave, one is Madhurya wave, one is Sakya wave, one is Dasya wave. Different waves, you know, he is displaying different type of waves of pastimes. And in those waves, every drop of water is one quality. Multiple qualities are released when he performs a pastime. Like if you see, when Sudama went to Dwaraka, Krishna showed, you know, freedom from false prestige by coming running to their gate and embracing, you know, Sudama. And then when he took him inside, he showed him intimacy. He showed him respect. He showed him gratitude for coming. He showed him affection. He rendered him service. So these are all like the droplets of water in that wave of pastime. Multiple qualities Krishna shows, bhakta vatsalata, madhurata, karunyata, apat bandhavata, anadha rakshakata, like that many qualities manifest in the pastimes. And these pastimes dance in the heart of the devotee. So see, this is very unique for Krishna. As you see in the picture, Yashoda is showing hand to Krishna like this. Lord Vishnu has no mother like this to control in the Vaikuntha. He is like the king and queen, Narayana and Lakshmi. They themselves are the supreme. Everybody is like their children. Whereas here you see Godhead gives up his godhood, controlled by his mother Yashoda. So here is stealing the butter. So this kind of Leela Madhurita is very rare, extremely rare. Therefore, Satyavrata Muni, in singing that song, Namameshwaram Sachit Anandarupam Lasat Kundalam Gokule Vrajamanam. He is saying, my dear Lord, you are Ishwara. Namami, I agree you are Ishwara, but I agree that you have Sachidananda Swarupam. You are not an ordinary baby. Your body is like a bluish sapphire which is made of Sachidananda Vigraha. So two very specific qualifications you mentioned so that we will not be bewildered by Krishna's activities. Right in the beginning, you are Ishwara, you are Sachidananda. And then he is saying, Lasat Kundalam Gokule Brajamanam, your ears, earrings are so beautifully shining. He is taking very close notice of Krishna. Lasat Kundalam Gokule Brajamanam. And he is saying in Ananda Gokulam, when you are running away from Mother Yashoda, that sight is very beautiful to see, he is saying. Yashoda Viyo Lukala Dhavamanam Paramrishtam Atyanta Todrutya Gopya. He's saying, look at this sight. Yashoda is taking a stick and running behind you. Huh? And you are turning to her and laughing and running, and she is laughing at you. You are laughing at her. What is the meaning of your laughter? You cannot catch me today. And she is laughing at you. What is the meaning of her laughter? I am not going to spare you today. Huh? Like that. So mother and son have a good understanding of each other. Huh? And you are running away. And then he is saying, this sight is the most sweet sight to see. And he is saying, how fortunate is this beautiful kundal, because it is repeatedly getting chance to kiss your cheeks. Like that it keeps coming and touching Krishna's cheeks. And because of Krishna's glow, bodily glow, Brahman, Brahma Jyoti, the kundal is also glowing. So the beauty of kundal has increased manifold, he is saying. So in this way, these are pastimes which he is adoring. Then atulya madhura prema mandita priya mandalah. See, Krishna is mandita with priya mandala. He is surrounded by his very loving servitors, and their love is not ordinary love, madhura prema. They have very, very sweet prema in their hearts. See, all of us, we all feel very safe and secure when you are with people who love you very much. Like many times I ask the students, which time of the year you like the most? They say summer vacation. Why summer vacation? Because you can be at home. Otherwise they will be in the hostel all the time. So people like going home. Why? Because at home resides the mother and father from whom they experience a lot of love and affection. And at home you are carefree. There is no tension. But when you are in the outside world, you become quite formal. Like when you go to somebody's house, you have to ask, sir, please may I come in? You have to ask. And other people are a little distanced from you. But at home, people are intimate with you and you get abundant love. Similarly, Krishna is surrounded by cows and calves who very intimately love him like a mother. They give him milk. And he is surrounded by his friends. You want to know how much his friends love Krishna? One day night, 11 o'clock, one covered boy came to Nanda Bhavan and said, hey Krishna, come, it's time for us to go to forest. And Yashoda came. She saw the fellow was half asleep. And Yashoda twisted his ears and said, hey, do you know what is the time now? Then he came to his external senses. She said, 11 o'clock at night, go and sleep now. You go to forest in the morning, 8 o'clock. So the boys loved Krishna so much, they will dream about Krishna. Even in sleep, they started having walking habit. To come and call Krishna to go to forest. So he is surrounded by such loving associates. Atulya madhura prema mandita priyamandalaha. Tri jagan mana sakarshi murali kalakojitaha. See, this is called Venu Madhurya. When Krishna plays on his flute, murali kalakojitaha, that sweetness of this flute is so powerful that it attracts all the three worlds. This is also described by Rupa Goswami. You will find in Padyavali many songs, poetry, describing about Krishna's pastimes. One of the descriptions given about Krishna's flute is, when Krishna plays on his flute, Brahma, who is doing puja in the puja room, he gets disturbed in his puja. Positively disturbed, positively distracted. He gives up the puja and says, I will continue puja later. Now I want to hear the flute now. And all the munis and brahmajnanis and everybody who are sitting, yogis sitting in the cave, oh, like that they are sitting in dhyana mudra. They give up their meditation and come out to hear the flute sound. They are attracted also. And all the apsaras start dancing in the heavens. and all the Gandharvas start singing. Kinnaras, Charanas, and they all start reciting mantras and glorification of Krishna like that when they hear the flute. And demigods flying in the sky with their wives, you know, seeing this Lord playing flute, they all come down to Vrindavan. They decide that few days we will spend in Vraja. Because Lord is playing on the flute, let us hear. See, the gopis are all intelligent. They are saying, the demigods in heaven are coming down to hear your flute. And the lower animals like the cows and calves and deers, they are all hearing your flute. Only we are the only one not allowed to hear your flute. Look at this, you know, irony, like that they are saying. So, if you want to know the sweetness of his murali, which Lord is playing, the calves are drinking the milk from their cow's udders, mother cow's udder, as soon as they hear the flute, they are stunned in ecstasy. See, there is one full chapter in Krishna book you will read, when gopis are meditating on Krishna's flute. There is one chapter. So, recently I was reading the chapter, there is so many lessons Prabhupada is deriving from that. He is saying that generally trees are very dull, but when Krishna plays on the flute, the trees are bowing down and giving their fruits to Krishna, flowers to Krishna. Even they become very conscious, he says. Yamuna is very fierce because she is sister of Yamaraj. But she becomes very mild when Krishna, she becomes mild and she throws a lotus in Krishna's lotus feet. Prabhupada says many things like that. The clouds generally rumble very loudly, da 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 da, like that. But when Krishna plays on the flute, the clouds rumble very softly. Because they don't want to disturb Krishna's flute. So you will find every creature, there only Prabhupada says, the cows are drinking milk from the mother cow's udders. When they heard the flute, they became confused. Which one to drink first, this one or this one? So which one you think they drank? They thought, as long as this is on, this will be off. After Krishna's flute stopped, then they sucked the milk after that. So that is his Venu Madhurya. Asamanor Dvarupa Shri Vismapita Characharaha. This is his Rupa Shri, his beauty. Asamana Urdhva. There is no beauty equal to Krishna's beauty. There is no beauty. Urdhva means greater than Krishna's beauty. Vismapita means what? He astonishes all the living beings, including Mahavishnu also. You see, Mahavishnu, there is one verse in the Bhagavatam. Yanmartya leela upayikam swayoga maya balam darshayata agrihitam vismapanam, same word is used there. Vismapanam swasya cha saubhagriddhe parampadam bhushana bhushanangam. This verse says, by yoga maya balam, by his own yoga maya, Krishna displayed such a beauty, seeing which even Vishnu became stunned. How do you know Mahavishnu became stunned? Therefore, he stole the four children of the Brahmanas, so that Krishna will come to Vaikuntha and he can see his beauty. Not only Mahavishnu is stunned, even Vasudev Krishna wants to see Vrindavan Krishna. Like that our Acharya has written, Vasudev Krishna has four hands. Vrindavan Krishna has only two hands. Vasudev Krishna lives in Mathura. Vrindavan Krishna lives in Vraja, Vrindavan. Therefore, when Akrura is taking Krishna Balaram in his chariot, do you think Krishna went out of Vrindavan? There is one secret thing that happens. Krishna stopped Akrura at the frontiers of Vrindavan and told, I want to go and take a bath in Yamuna. At that time in Yamuna, he saw Krishna with four hands. So Akrura sees that. Why? Krishna said, like Vrindavanam parityajya padamekam nagachati. Krishna will not leave Vrindavan and go. So Vrindavan Krishna remained back and he sent whom? His own expansion, Vasudev Krishna with four hands. That personality goes to Mathura. Like that. So his Rupa Madhurya can be explained with that beautiful song. Adaram Madhuram Vadanam Madhuram Adaram Madhuram Nayanam Madhuram Hasitam Madhuram Nayanam Madhuram Hasitam Madhuram Hridayam Madhuram Gamanam Madhuram Hridayam Madhuram Gamanam Vallabhacharya singing, he's saying when Krishna is playing on the flute in the moonlit night, the moon beams fall on his lips and the lips are shining beautifully. That's very attractive, he says. Then his face is itself like a full moon. He's called Vrindavan Chandra. You see here, Vrindavan Chandra, you see here? He's Vrindavan Chandra. And his Nayana Madhuram, his eyes are like lotus petals. Hasitam Madhuram, his smile is very beautiful. Yeah, and Hridayam Madhuram, his heart is so sweet because how he treated Sudama, how he treats all living beings. Even Putana, he gave her the position of a mother in spiritual world. When he walks to forest, his lotus feet are very beautiful. Finally, he said, which part of Krishna can I glorify? Akilam Madhuram, he said. Everything about him is beautiful, he said. Venur Madhura Renur Madhura Panir Madhura Padav Madhura Panir Madhura Padav Nrityam Madhuram Sakhyam Madhuram Madhura Adipate Akiram Madhuram Madhura Adipate Madhura Adipate Akiram Madhuram Madhura Adipate. In this way you will see he is glorifying his Venu. Renu means the dust of his feet, because the dust of Krishna's lotus feet delivered Kaliya. And his hand palms are also very beautiful, with which he wipes out the wounds in the body of Arjuna in a moment. And Pada Madhura, his lotus feet are very beautiful. He is saying, and they deliver the devotee from all the sinful reactions. They destroy the sinful reactions. His Nrityam is very Madhuram on the hoods of Kaliya, isn't it? Sakhyam with Arjuna, his friendship with Arjuna is very beautiful. One last one we will sing. Geetam Madhuram, Geetam Madhuram, Geetam Madhuram, Geetam Madhuram, Bhuktam Madhuram, Suktam Madhuram. Rupam Madhuram, Tilakam Madhuram, Madhuradhipate, Akilam Madhuram, Madhuradhipate, Akilam Madhuram. So, his Gita Madhuram is Bhagavad Gita is very sweet. Pita means Pitambar. Bhukta means when he sits in the bank of Yamuna with all the covered boys and eats Vanabhoj. Very beautiful to see that. Suptam means even when he is sleeping, like as Anganatha, he is lying down in snake bed. It's very beautiful to look at. And his rupam, his form is very beautiful. His kasturi telakam dalaka patale, that's very beautiful. So in this way, Krishna's beauty is described. His rupa dhyanam. This song is about rupa madhurya. Now finally he is putting all the four together. Please repeat this. Leela premna priyadikyam. Madhuryam Venu Rupayoho Ityasadharanam Proktam Govindasya Chatushtayam Yeah. See, four things. Leela, Premna. Leela is the pastimes. Premna Priyadikyam means his friends surrounding him. And Madhuryam. And Venarupaya. Venarupaya means, Venu means the Murali which we said. Venu Madhurya and Rupa Madhurya. So, Leela Madhurya, Bhakta Madhurya, Venu Rupa Madhurya, Rupa Madhurya. All the four are put in one here. So, in this way, just as we described about Krishna now, Radharani is actually an expansion of Krishna, who is also called Bhagavati. Krishna is called Bhagavan, she is called Bhagavati. Krishna is called Supreme Personality of Godhead, she is called Supreme Personality of Servitor of Godhead. She acts as a servant of Krishna, supreme servant. Nobody can match her servitorship. See here, in Bhagavad Gita there are two verses. Don't get frightened by seeing that. Because there is one material Devi, there is a spiritual Devi. In the material world, who is the material Devi? Durga Devi. And in the spiritual world, who is spiritual Devi? Radharani. So, in Bhagavad Gita there are two Devi verses. Anybody can guess what are those two Devi verses? We'll repeat those two verses. Daivi hi esha gunamayi. Mama maya duratyaya. Mame vaye prapadyante. Maya metam tarantite. Who is this Devi? Daivi hi esha gunamayi. Durga Devi. So, Durga Devi, sometimes you see in Calcutta, Bhadrakali, she has the multiple weapons in the hand, tongue like this outside, isn't it? And the Trishul in the hand. So, why is she is actually Krishna's sister only, but why is she so angry? She is angry that the jivas are all mischievous and diplomatic and cunning and exploitative. They are all in Bhogavritti, exploiting the energies of the Lord, not surrendering to the Lord and wasting their lives. So, she is very angry. She punishes them with Trishul, which is Adhyatmika, Adibhautika, Adidaivika. So the material world is compared to smoke. Smoke always troubles. It doesn't serve. But the spiritual world is compared to fire, Prabhupada says. So in the spiritual world, there is a spiritual Devi. Who is that? Radharani. You have seen in Mayapur, Radha Madhav, and Radharani is carrying a garland in her hand. In one hand, she is holding a, you know, bouquet, flower bouquet. And on the other hand, she is holding a garland. So, flower bouquet is to welcome you to spiritual world. And the other garland is to garland for Krishna, Madhav. So, on one hand, she is serving Radha Madhav. On the other hand, she is welcoming the jivas. Come here, come here. Because you go to any meeting, what do they show you? They show you a flower bouquet or a trishul. If they show you a trishul, what is the meaning? Don't come again. Correct, no? So, Durga is showing trishul. Means, she's telling, get out of the material world. And Radharani is saying, here is a flower bouquet, you are welcome. So we all are getting welcome in spiritual world and quit India, Gandhi said, no? Similarly, she's saying, quit material world. She's telling. So Durga is saying, quit the material world and Radharani is saying, welcome to spiritual world. So what you have to do? You have to just do what they are telling. Very simple, isn't it? So what is Radharani's verse? Please repeat this verse. Mahatmanastu mam partha. Daivim prakritim ashritah. Bhajantyananya manaso. Jnatva bhutadim avyayam. So, this verse says about which Devi? Radharani, it says. It says, Mahatma devotees take shelter of Radharani, it says. Daivim prakritim ashritah. And they always do ananya bhakti to Radha and Krishna. At every moment. And then they are taken back to Godhead. So Radharani is called Antaranga Shakti and Durga is called Bahiranga Shakti. One is internal potency, one is external potency, you see. See, one time, this is a Madan. You see Madan, he is surrounded by Rati and other ladies, Apsaras. So he carries a sugarcane bough, you are seeing that? And he has a flower arrow with which he is attacking all of us in this world. So he sends the flower arrow and hits the heart of the living entities, both whether man or woman, whoever it be. Therefore, sometimes a man looks at a woman or a woman looks at a man. Suddenly when the flower arrow is sent by Madan, Just like they put a picture of the heart and the arrow. That job is done by whom? Mother and Cupid. It's done by the Cupid. So what is the result of that? People go become pagal. Correct? They go mad. A man becomes mad for a woman, or a woman becomes mad for a man. Adamantly they want to chase after that man or woman. They become crazy. Is it not true? So this fellow was going around. So one time he did the mischief with whom? Lord Shiva. Do you know what happened? Shiva is meditating in Kailash. See, Shiva burnt him with the third eye. He became burnt to ashes. Then again he had to take rebirth. That time. So Shiva became angry on Kamadev. But the same fellow, but another time you find Shiva is running after Mohini Murthy. And with the same fellow wanted to attack Krishna also in Dwaraka. Why? Because he came to know that Krishna has five patranis, very chief queens, very beautiful. And then he has 16,108 queens, and all of them exquisitely beautiful. They are wearing beautiful saris and ornaments, and their bodies are extremely beautiful. They all had sidelong glances and beautiful hair and everything. So he thought this is the best opportunity. So I will go and agitate the mind of Krishna. So I can show you a verse. There's a verse in the Bhagavatam which says, that verse says, I'll show you that verse. You can see the full verse. Uddama bhava pishuna malaval guhasa vrida avaloka nihato madano piyasam sammukhya chapamajahat pramadottamasta yasyendriyam vimatithum kuhakairna shekuhu. Here it's like, although the Dwaraka queens, beautiful smiles and furtive glances were all spotless and exciting, and although they could conquer Cupid himself by making him give up his bow in frustration, and although even the tolerant Shiva could fall victim to them, still, despite all their magical feats and attractions, they could not agitate the senses of Lord Krishna. See? Yasya indriyam vimatitum kuhakair na shekuhu. It is said. Kuhakair means magic. The queens of Dwaraka had a magical beauty. But they could not agitate Krishna's senses. Only one thing agitated Krishna's mind with the Dwaraka queens. What was it? The seva bhav. When the Dwaraka queens wanted to feed prasad to Krishna, wanted to fan Krishna, wanted to comb Krishna, wanted to wash his feet, Krishna was deeply touched by their seva bhav. So whether you are a beautiful woman, you are a young boy, you are a child, you are an old man, you are a calf, you are a cow. It's immaterial for Krishna who you are. He only sees, he has the X-ray vision to see the seva bhav in your heart. That's all. Therefore, Radharani is able to attract Krishna because she has the highest seva bhava. She has the ocean of seva bhava. So that is what is the only thing that attracts Krishna. Okay, how do you say confidently about this? Because Krishna was attracted to Kubja, correct, no? Was Kubja beautiful? So what was beautiful about Kubja? Her service attitude. Correct, no? So what was beautiful in Shabari? That Lord Rama was attracted to her. Her desire to feed Lord Rama, isn't it? So we all have to cultivate Seva Bhav in us. If you have Seva Bhav, you will become very attractive to Krishna. Anybody who has even a little of Seva Bhav. See, Putana was doing a drama of a mother, not even real mother. She said, I want to feed milk, but what she wanted to feed? Still Krishna accepted, because that seva bhav wanting to feed milk attracted him. In the previous life, she actually had a desire. She was sister of Bali Maharaj. When she saw Vamanadev, the beautiful young Brahmana boy, coming with an umbrella, with a kamandalu, you know, his face was like milk, so pure, innocent child. She immediately felt, what a beautiful child. If I had a son like this, I would have fed my milk to this child. She had a bhav like that, feeling abhilasha like that. But the next moment, you know what Vamanadev did? He expanded himself as Trivikrama. Then she was gritting her teeth and said, I want to kill this fellow because he is taking away all the property of my brother. So she wanted to feed milk also and killed also. So then what happened next life? She became Putana. So she gave milk also and Of course, nobody can kill Krishna, so she herself got killed. But the point is, Krishna took her bhav very seriously. So this is one takeaway lesson for us. Radharani has an ocean of seva bhav. We can pray to her today, please give me a drop of your service attitude, Radharani ji. Please repeat this verse. Radha Krishna Yeka Atma Duhi Deha Dari.
Radha Krishna Yeka Atma Duhi Deha Dari.
Anyonya Vilase Rasa Aswadana Kari. This is what I told you. Radha and Krishna are Yeka Atma, means what? They are one soul. But Duhi Deha Dari, they accepted two bodies to perform beautiful pastimes, to give happiness to all of us jivas. See, how Radharani gives happiness is explained in this song. Who has mridangam? Rasalasya gita narma sakkalali pandita prema ramya rupa vesha sadgunali mandita. Rasalasya gita narma prema ramya rupa vesha sadgunali pandita Vishwana Vyagopayo Hridali Topiyadika Makhyam Atma Pada Padma Dasya Dastu Radhika See, I told you, this is a picture you can see. In the top you are seeing Shiva and Parvati showering flowers. And Brahma and Saraswati. You are seeing many demigods are showering flowers from the top. See Indra. Indra is travelling in a flight which has got Airavat elephant. You are seeing that? On that extreme right side. Airavat elephant, he is showering flowers. And Radha and Krishna are in the center. And all the, between every two gopis, Krishna expanded himself. This is a transcendental dance. And which is allowed entry only for very great souls. See, this is the translation of what we sang just now. She is very learned in many transcendental arts, such as performing in the rasa dance, singing and joking. She is decorated with many divine qualities, such as loving nature, exquisite beauty and wonderful garments and ornaments. Even among the covered damsels of Raja, who are praised by the entire universe, she is the best in every way. May Sri Radhika bestow upon me the service of her own lotus feet. This is one of the eight stanzas of Radhikashtakam. So, you can see all the 64 kalas emanate from her. Dancing, singing, joking, dressing, playing games, rangoli. All these things come from Radharani. So, this is the verse I told you in the beginning of the class today. Vikriditam Vrajavadu Viridam Cha Vishnu. So this verse says actually you will become a dhira by hearing these pastimes. We are going to sing one song and conclude the talk now. Radhe jaya jaya madhava daite.
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 Gokula karuni Mandala Mahite,
Gokula Karuni,
Mandala Mahite, Radhe Jaya Jaya Madhava,
Radhe Jaya Jaya Madhava,
Damodara Rati, Vardana Veshe, Hari Nishkurta Vanga Vipineshe.
Hari Nishkurta Vanga Vipineshe.
Vishavanudade
Navasachilekhe Dalita Saki Gurdaramita Vikake Karunam kuru mai karuna bharite sanaka sanaka varnita charite
So, such a beautiful expansion of Krishna's own form, Srimati Radharani, who is actually the chief supreme goddess of all goddesses, one who is bestower of service to all the living entities, one who is the supreme mother, universal mother, Jagatera Mata, it is a Jagan Mata, mother of all the jivas. So she appeared today as the little beautiful golden daughter of Vrishabhanu and Kirtida. So Vrishabhanu and Kirtida were Suchandra and Kalavati in their previous lives. They also performed penances just like Devaki and Vasudeva performed, eating only dry leaves for 10,000 years. So they also had performed very severe penances. But their desire was to get Goddess of Fortune as their daughter. So on this particular day, Brahma personally appeared in a particular lake when Vrishabhanu went one morning to Yamuna. He saw in Yamuna a beautiful shining golden lotus. And in that golden lotus was lying a beautiful little baby girl who had a golden complexion. So Vrishabhanu and Kirtida always had a desire to have a child. And when as soon as Vrishabhanu saw the child, Brahma came down and picked up the child and handed over to Vrishabhanu and told that she will be your child now. You had an aspiration to have Goddess of Fortune as your child. So Vrishabhanu and Kirtida, they were simultaneously happy and unhappy. Why? They were happy that now they got a daughter of their choice, but they were unhappy that the daughter wouldn't open her eyes. So one time Narada Muni, when he came to know Krishna has appeared in this world, 15 days later Radharani appears. So he thought that because Lord has appeared, naturally Goddess of Fortune must have appeared also somewhere. So he searched all over Vraja, everywhere. At last he went to the home of Vrishabhanu and he was curious to ask him whether you got a daughter. When he asked about his children, he just brought Sri Rama and introduced Sri Rama to Narada. So Narada touched Yadama's head and blessed him that you will become a great associate of Krishna. He blessed him. And then Vrishabhanu very reluctantly told him that I also have got a daughter, but I am very hesitant to introduce you to her because this child is blind. She is not opening her eyes. So then Narada was very eager, please take me. So when he was taken inside, Narada told Vrishabhanu, you may be very busy with household chores. I don't want to disturb you. You carry on. You know, I will see your child. So after he went away, Narada circumambulated the child several times and he fell at her feet crying tears, that because as soon as he saw Goddess of Fortune, he could recognize. And Radharani also reciprocated by immediately showing her Kaishori form, along with her Lalita, Vishaka and all other associates. They all manifested. After seeing her in that form, again he fainted unconscious. And offered many, many, many Sanskrit poetry, prayers, circumambulating her several times. And he had tears in his eyes. When he came out, Vrishabhanu was wondering, why is he crying? This great sage, the great Narada couldn't tell him anything, any words. But later on, Radharani opened her eyes for the first time when Yashoda, Nanda and Krishna came to their house. When Krishna lifted himself up to see in the cradle, for the first time, at that time Radharani opened her eyes. which teaches all of us a very important lesson. Use your eyes only to see Krishna. Don't see cinema posters. Don't see useless movies. Use only our eyes to see Krishna. That is Radharani. Wherever she sees only Krishna only, everywhere. It's called Devi Krishnamayi Prokta. Krishnamayi means she is Krishnamaya always. So, so much can be said. I don't want to exceed the time, but here you can see, taking shelter of Radharani, last part. We need to serve the mission of Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda. They reveal how to take shelter of Radharani and mercifully give us that shelter. One place, it's written, I read it personally myself. Those who take shelter of Nityananda Prabhu, they are handed over Nityananda Prabhu to Radharani. And they only get service. So who is Nityananda Prabhu's representative in our life? A special master. Therefore, without taking shelter of spiritual master and attaining Diksha and coming in the disciplic line, we cannot get service from Radharani. So therefore, one should begin worshipping Gaur Nithai. And through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu, we can understand Radha Krishna Leela very easily. Yeah, this I already told you, this famous verse. What happens when we take shelter of Srimati Radharani? Look at Srila Prabhupada, even in the old age, he bowed down before Radha and Krishna. Prabhupada is saying, by bowing down, we get protection. Although we have got Krishna's qualities, still we sometimes fall down. So we require protection, he says. So, therefore we chant Hare Krishna, not alone Krishna. First we say Hare first. Hare is who? Srimati Radharani. Vrindavan, everybody chants Jai Radhe. Yeah. We can pray to her, please give us the intelligence by which we can take shelter of Krishna perfectly. This is Radha Kund. You can see Radharani's face also in Radha Kund. So many devotees go to Vrindavan taking shelter of Radharani to attend devotion service. See, Prabhupada is saying, how to pray to Radharani, Prabhupada is saying. Oh, my mother, Radharani, Jagannamata, if you kindly take this flower and offer it to Krishna, please take it. So you give a flower in the hand of Radharani, and what she will do? Oh, you have brought a flower for Krishna. She will happily accept it and offer it to Krishna. When we give it, Krishna may not turn to us, because Krishna will wonder, are you millions of lifetimes, where were you? You are roaming here and there, suddenly you are coming and offering a flower, as if you have fallen in love with me. But if Radharani gives Krishna, he will definitely accept it, because she is a personification of, she is an abode of love. So he can act. Therefore, instead of we giving, we can request Radharani to give. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna in the mood of Radharani, Mahabhava Prakasha. Mahabhava Swarupini Radha Takurani. So Mahaprabhu exhibited this mood, chanted and danced and cried in separation from Krishna. All his life he taught this. Gopi Bhava, he taught this. So such feelings of separation from Krishna, like you can see in all these different pastimes Mahaprabhu taught us. Therefore Prabhupada says it is very safe for us to learn Radha Krishna Leela through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We can never misunderstand, because he is a sannyasi. And you can see he is surrounded by all associates. Ramananda Rai is Vishakasaki. Swarup Damodar is Lalita Sakhi, but they are all in male forms in Chaitanya Leela. So therefore one will not misunderstand these pastimes. So let us take shelter of Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. So thanks to Srila Prabhupada, who brought us this Mahamantra and Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Panchatattva Mantra, who taught us, by doing which he has made our life so simple, easy, sublime and so sweet. It was Srila Prabhupada who gave a very level-headed, proper understanding of Radha and Krishna, so that we will not get confused or bewildered. In India there are so many people speaking on Rasa Leela and everything, bewildering and confusing the people. Prabhupada gave a very solid foundation of philosophy in his small books and medium books and all. And then he gave us Bhagavad Gita as it is, after which we should study Srimad Bhagavatam. Thanks to Srila Prabhupada for his pure presentation of the Siddhanta. Therefore now the whole world is able to taste this Krishna Bhakti, Radha Krishna Bhakti, which is very rare for the jivas. Some jivas may work for moksha or they may get siddhis. Muktim dadati kare chitsmana bhakti yogam. Lord says, I will even give mukti very easily, but bhakti I don't give. But that rare bhakti, Lord Chaitanya gave 500 years ago and Prabhupada made it more easy for us. So, today on this Radhastami day, we will pray to Srila Prabhupada that by His grace, let us develop a proper understanding of the subject of Radha and Krishna. And we can pray to Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that we go through the parampara and let clarity come to our sight. Let Shraddha and faith come in our heart for the devotion to Sri Radha and Krishna. Because there is nothing beyond this. Prabhupada says, love is the last word in transcendence, he says. And that love of Radha and Krishna, and love of Radharani for the jivas, and the love of the jivas for Krishna, everything is centered around love. That pure love is offered to us in this wonderful Guru Parampara of Brahma Madhva, Gaudiya Sampradaya. Shri Radharani ki, Shri Shri Radha Shyam Sundar ki, Shri Radhe Gopal Bhaj Man Shri Radhe Shri Radhe Gopal Bhaj Man Shri Radhe Shri Radhe Shri Radhe Shri Radhe Shri Radhe Gopal Bhaj Man Gopala Gopala Nandalala Shri Radhe Shri Radhe Gopala Nandalala Thank you.